I reckon pretty soon we'll be getting unsupervised visits from just about anyone we like.
Eh? How come?
Well, if I can get one from Ken, I reckon anyone can. Well, what's the matter, cat? Got your tongues?
I reckon old Davo bought you off, Bee.
Yeah. How about all that publicity stuff and the screws interfering and everything?
Davo will look after that. She wants this scheme to be a success.
She said that, did she? Your friend, Mrs. Davidson?
Now, what is that supposed to mean?
I'll tell you what it means. It means you sold us out. All this big talk about standing together. Not letting the screws walk all over us. You couldn't give a bugger.
Just you watch it, Chrissie.
Unsupervised visits were on the go anyway. How do you think I saw Mick? You reckon you're top dog, do you? Top bloody suck, more like it.
Isn't anyone going to have a round of cards with me?
Oh, come on, what is wrong with you lot?
What do you think we should do with a bitch who sells her mates out to the screws, then?
Hard to think of anything bad enough, really.
They dangle the bribe of shacking up with her boyfriend in front of her, and we can all go to hell. I mean, it doesn't matter that we missed out on our visits, does it? Well, I'm damned if I'm going to take orders from the likes of her.
Yeah, me
neither.
Not
from someone who sucks up to the screws, anyway.
All right. I did not suck up to the screws and I did not sell you out. Now, have you got that straight?
Oh, yeah. That doesn't explain why you did it.
Look, we boycotted the visiting suite to make a point, didn't we? The visits were not completely unsupervised, nor was everyone eligible for them. It was nowhere near as rosy as it sounded in the newspapers.
Yeah, but that still doesn't explain why you did what you did, Bee.
Well, I've won a point, haven't I? Davo has promised that from now on the visits will be completely unsupervised. Well, we'll see if they stick to their word. My visit with Ken is a test case.
Oh, yeah, your visit was a bloody test case. Why couldn't it have been mine? I mean, why must you always get your own way?
You stupid bitch, you've never been able to see past the nose in your face. Can't you see I've won something for everyone?
You just want something for yourself, Bee. You couldn't give two hoots about the rest of us, just as long as you get what you want.
I'll knock your stupid bloody head off.
Oh, yeah! Come on, you're the selfish one. You're always on
that noise. What's going on here?
What's going on?
On the outside. I said, what's going on?
Oh, nothing much. A little debate got out of hand, that's all.
I want to see Mrs. Davidson.
It's far too late for that, Latham. You can see her tomorrow.
I want to see her now or there's going to be trouble.
Are you threatening me, Latham?
No, Miss Bennett. But there's trouble brewing here and it's going to come to a head if you don't let me see the governor now.
All right, come with me. And the rest of you had better be quiet.
Come in.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
There's some sort of friction between the women. I've just broken up a screaming match in the recreation room. The ringleaders seem to be Smith and Latham.
Oh, you'd think Smith would be on top of the world at the moment.
Yes, Latham's outside. She insisted on seeing you. I know it's late, but
no, it's all right. I'd better get to the bottom of it.
In here, Latham.
Is something the matter, Latham?
I say it is. Bloody Smith told us we had to give up our private visits. Said she was going to bash us if we didn't. Now her bloke can come in on a visit. It's all on again, and I've bloody missed out.
What's your language, Latham?
Are you saying that Smith forced you to refuse your conjugal visit?
Yeah. She made us all give them up just because she was jealous. Didn't have a bloke to visit her, did she? But now he is. It's all right. So I want my visit with Mick arranged like it was.
You've already had your visit.
I know, but not alone like it was promised.
You know it's against the rules to have two visits in 1 week.
Oh, that Smith's got a lot to answer for, and I'm going to make sure she bloody well does.
That's enough of that.
Your case is due to come up before the parole board next week. You would be very foolish to do anything that would jeopardize the chances of your release. After all, you do have a baby to consider.
Yeah, you're right.
Then you would be unwise to do anything that would cause unnecessary attention to yourself before your case is reviewed.
Okay. I'll pull me head in, Mrs. Davidson. I just want to get out, that's all.
You can have your unsupervised visit next week. If you're still here, of course, I hope you won't be.
Oh, thanks.
You can take her back now, Miss Bennett.
What if there's more trouble?
I'm sure there won't be.
No, there won't be. Not from me, anyway.
Come on, Latham.
Thanks for putting me straight, Mrs. Davidson.
I'm glad Mrs. Davidson mentioned about my parole. I don't want nothing mucking that up.
That's if the parole board have the time to consider your case.
Yeah, they didn't last time.
The time before that parole was turned down, wasn't it? Mm. Because of a detrimental report from Mr. Gillespie?
Yeah, I'm glad he's not here now.
But of course, reports from the officers will be taken into account. I wouldn't get my hopes up too high if I were you.
You saying I might not get it at all?
You can hardly expect all the reports to be in your favour, Latham.
No. Not if you're putting one in, Miss Bennett, I can't.
I'll put one in, all right. Ironic, isn't it? You have to let Smith get away with what she's done because of your parole, which you mightn't even be getting.
Yeah.
I heard there was some trouble between Smith and Latham. Were you able to sort it out?
Yes, I reminded Latham that her parole was coming up next week. She's so eager to see her daughter, I don't think we'll have any more trouble with her.
I gather that she really cares for the child.
Oh, yes, there's been quite a change in her since Elizabeth was born. She's become fiercely maternal.
Hmm. Well, I don't know her very well. She's never signed on for any of my classes.
Well, I think she's been far too busy working to make as much money as she can to support her daughter. Perhaps you should have a talk with her and persuade her to sign on for one of your courses.
But if she's likely to be paroled next week...
Well, to be honest, that's why I suggested it. It would be all in her favour if the report indicated she'd taken an interest in the prison facilities. Then if by chance she doesn't get her release, well, doing one of your courses might help her get a better chance when she is released.
Right, well, I'll speak to her in the morning. But there's not much doubt about a parole, is there?
Oh, no, I don't think so.
All right, Latham, behave yourself. Not that I can see it'll make much difference.
So, you didn't get much joy out of Mrs. Davidson, hey? She couldn't care less, could she? Not whilst everything's running smoothly.
You're bloody rotten, Bee. I've got to wait a week now for a private visit from Mick.
Oh, stop bellyaching, Chrissie. We all agreed to the boycott and it was for everyone's good.
You soon forgot about everyone's good when it suited you, though, didn't you? All you cared about is what you wanted.
So you missed out. So tough.
You... Kill you!
Oh, you and who's
that? That's enough. You're going to solitary, Latham.
It wasn't my fault.
I think I can safely say you've ruined your chance of parole. Keep an eye on them.
It wasn't my fault. It wasn't. It's pushing
me away. Hope you're satisfied now, B. Oh, God, I hope my eye doesn't go black. That damn Chrissie needs taking down a peg or two.
Don't you reckon losing a parole was bad enough?
Well, it's not my fault if she loses it. I didn't ask the silly bitch to come at me, now did I?
Well, you can't blame her. She was upset.
Oh, no, you can't blame her. Can't blame anybody. Not where you've all got me to blame. You know, I didn't think you'd turn against me too, Lizzie.
I'm not turning against you, Bee. I just can't stand by in this. What you did was pretty lousy, I reckon.
You just don't understand, do you?
Blood oath, I don't. Neither do the others. They're not calling you top dog anymore. They're calling you top suck.
Well, if that's the way they feel, they can stick it. I am sick to death of wet noosing that lot anyway. Let's just see how they get on without me for a change.
Good morning, Miss Bennett.
Oh, you've seen my report.
Yes, were either of the women hurt?
No, not really. They'll both have a few bruises this morning, though.
Hmm. Well, if there's nothing more serious, you can release Latham from solitary.
But they were brawling. Mrs. Davidson, what are we going to do about Smith? Surely you won't allow her to have her visit.
There are likely to be a few such cases until the jealousy about unsupervised visits dies down. I want all the officers to be on guard in case anyone gets hurt, but you can ignore any petty squabbling.
You mean you're not going to discipline them for fighting?
I think it's better to let the women sort it out for themselves rather than to come down too heavily on them. Now, would you please release Latham from solitary?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Ken Pierce.
Good morning, Mr. Pierce. Erica Davidson from Wentworth. I wanted to let you know it's been decided to allow you an unsupervised visit with B. Smith. That is, if you would like one.
Well, that's great, Mrs. Davison. Unsupervised visits are a real breakthrough for Wentworth.
Of course, they will be discontinued immediately if the privilege is abused.
No, you needn't worry about me, Mrs. Davison. I won't cause you any problems. When can I come over? I see not for 3 days. No, I understand. Rules are rules. Well, thank you, Mrs. Davison. I appreciate that. Thank you and goodbye.
Come on, Latham. You've got off this time.
You're kidding!
I'm not in the habit of kidding. For her own reasons, Mrs. Davidson has decided to turn a blind eye to your behaviour.
Oh, good old David!
Now, come on, I've got work to do. Mr. Andrews wants to speak to you in the library.
Oh, I wonder what he wants. Maybe he fancies me.
Don't think that you can get away with any more of this nonsense. You step out of line once more and Mrs. Davidson will have to report it. Now, you just remember that.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
Okay, girl, smoke her. Oh, come on. How long are you lot going to keep this up? All right. I am fed up to the back teeth with you anyway. Let someone else do all the planning for you for a change, and they can operate the press as well. I'm taking over this machine.
Some people would just get lost.
Are you going to get off that chair, or do I have to knock you off?
Can you lend us a fancy? Some people around here, they think they can boss everyone around. Well, I'll soon find out it doesn't work no more.
Well, from now on, I am looking after number one. And if anyone gets in my way, I'll smack them in the mouth. Oh, don't say you weren't warned.
Somebody's got to work the press. What about you, Dore?
You can do it.
Oh, I'm not strong enough.
Well, I don't want to do it, and I'm sick of all this bloody carry-on anyway.
You can work it, Jude.
Yeah?
Well...
All right, but I'm not top dog or anything. It's just that somebody's got to work the damn thing.
I thought you might have stuck by me.
Look, B, I don't want to end up being the meat in the sandwich between you and them. I think the whole thing is really stupid and I don't want to hear about it anymore.
Thanks, friend.
Well, doesn't seem to be much work going on around here.
Mr. Fletcher, can I go and work somewhere else, please?
Why is that, Burns?
Well, it's nice to have a change every now and again. Maybe I could work in the kitchen or do some cleaning duties or something. Anything to get out of here for a while.
I'll see what I can do. Come on.
Debbie!
Hi, Dad.
Hey, how long can you stay?
A few days. I want to do some shopping.
Be a trousseau?
Trousseau? Oh, that sounds so old-fashioned, but yeah, I guess that's what it's for. Thought I'd lob in on you for some free accommodation.
Well, I'd have been disappointed if you hadn't. How's your mum?
Oh, she's fine.
And Peter?
Oh, he's great. Staying to get cold feet about the wedding bit, though.
Hey, he's not going to leave you waiting at the church, is he?
Oh, he better not. Oh, it's terrific to see you again, Dad.
You can come and stay any time you want to. There's always a place for you here.
Oh, thanks. I'll remember that. But Mum gets pretty lonely. And she's going to feel it all the more when I move out and set up my own home.
Yeah, I suppose she will.
Well, you look just about snowed under. What are you doing?
Oh, same as usual. Organising prison drama groups, some liaison work for newly released prisoners, and if there's any time left over, the PRG.
Oh, same old Dad.
Got to keep busy.
Have you seen anything of B. Smith lately?
Yes, I went to visit her last week.
How is she?
She's well. Well, as you can be on the inside.
Oh, I often think of her, you know. She really opened up to me.
Yeah, I'll never forget what she did for you.
It's rotten to think of her stuck in there all those years. Doesn't give her much to look forward to. Unless she has someone waiting for her. How serious are you about her, Dad?
Serious? Well, how can I be serious about anyone? I'm still a married man.
Oh, yeah. Ball and chain still intact, hey? You're not thinking about divorce or anything, are you?
Not at the moment, no. Look, what brought this on? Your mother?
Oh, No, it's just that you've been apart so long now, I thought you might have made a decision, one way or the other.
No, I haven't made any decisions at all. I've been far too busy. Hey, would you like some coffee?
Yeah, I'd love some.
What are your plans for the future, Chrissie?
Well, all I'm interested in is getting out of here and getting Elizabeth back.
But what sort of work were you hoping to get? Have you any qualifications?
No, they don't give qualifications for what I've done, do they? But there was this social worker once, and she told me that I'm entitled to a single mother's pension.
That's right, but it's not much.
Oh, well, that don't worry me. Get myself a little job, you know, part-time, cleaning a house, something like that. Get some more dough, I'll be all right.
But who'll care for Elizabeth while you're working?
Well, I've got some friends who'd like to help. If only I could get out of here. Fat chance of that, though, isn't it? Not much chance of me getting my parole, is there?
Why do you say that?
Well, it only takes one bad report from an officer and I'm gone. They've already knocked me back twice, you know. An old vinegar tits, well, she... I mean, Miss Bennett.
God, I hate to think what they call me. Listen, Chrissie, I think you've got a chance this time. Now, Mrs. Davidson's right behind you. The important thing is to make a good impression on the parole board.
How am I going to do that? The only thing I'm good at is lying on me back. Here, you reckon any of them would be interested?
Now, I suggest you play it very straight when they interview you.
Oh, yeah, I will.
Now, I realise you wanted to work in here as much as possible. We'll get some money together. But it'd look better on your record if you did some study.
Study? You mean arithmetic and history? Oh, look, I'm not any good at that.
No, I was thinking of something more practical. There's a course on modern living. This would be useful to you, even if you were released before you complete it.
Well, I'm interested in anything that's going to get me out of here.
Right, we'll just show up to classes. Have a look at this first. This will give you an idea of what it's all about.
All right. Thanks.
Okay.
Oh, by the way, we do have a name for you. Randy Andy.
Okay, if that's the way you feel. I just wanted to tell you, you don't have to stop working in the laundry because of me, you know.
Yeah, well, I just didn't want to be any part of it. I reckon it's really stupid and it's all going to blow over in a few days.
No, I don't reckon it is. Not that easy. Things have changed and I am not top dog anymore.
Yeah, but you will get on top again. Just knock a few heads together. That ought to do it.
Oh, I can't bash all of them, can I? Anyway, that's not what it's all about. Just being heavy. I was top dog because the women looked up to me and they don't anymore.
Yeah, well, I'll still be your friend, B, just as long as I don't get mixed up in any fights.
Anything for peace and quiet, eh?
Yeah. Well, when you haven't got anybody on the outside, you need to keep your mates on the inside. They're all you've got.
I haven't got anyone, then.
I said I'd still be your friend, B. Anyway, you have got somebody on the outside. You've got Ken.
Yeah, and I'm seeing him in 3 days' time in the visiting suite.
Yeah, well, that'll be terrific for you.
Depends. I don't really know how Ken feels about me. He might not even be interested.
Oh, of course he is.
Yeah. If he is. But I don't need this lot. Let someone else have the problems of being boss cocky for a while. I'm just going to think of me and Ken.
It will be necessary to search Ken Pierce before he sees B. Smith and again when he leaves.
Right.
However, I want them to be left completely alone during the visit. I can't stress this too strongly. The success of the whole scheme depends upon it.
You mean Smith's got us over a barrel. If she approves the scheme, it stays.
Well, you've got to face facts, Vera. Smith has a lot of influence over the women.
If you ask me, it's immoral for her to be left alone with a man she hasn't even a relationship with.
We're not advocating free love for the prisoners. A more liberal approach to security might help the women develop some self-discipline.
Well, in the past, tight security hasn't helped matters, so I suppose it's worth giving this a go.
Of course it is.
Well, it seems my opinions count for nothing, as usual.
Your opinions have been noted, Miss Bennett. Oh, yes, you'll be pleased to know that Mrs. Morris starts her new job as a welfare officer tomorrow.
Well, she won't actually be working here, will she?
She'll be stationed in a city office, but she will be here quite a lot. Wentworth is to be her main area of work.
Well, she'll need an office to work out of. The social worker's office has been used for a storeroom for quite a while now. I'll have it cleaned out for her.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher. Her work will involve mainly probationers and parolees, but I would like her to have the freedom to see the women at any time in the interview room or their cells until the office is ready.
We'll give her all the help she needs.
Good.
Here, B, it's all I've got.
Oh, thanks, Doreen. Never bothered buying any makeup for myself. Never had anyone to wear it for. Oh, look at that, got skin like leather.
I wouldn't be surprised if Ken takes one look and runs the other way.
Oh, don't be silly.
I'll shove some on later. Bit of camouflage never hurt.
Really looking forward to it, aren't you?
Yeah, it's been a long time.
Hope it's real romantic for you, Bee.
Well, like I said, nothing might happen. But if it does, I won't be knocking it back.
All right, ladies, mail. Stokes.
Oh,
great. Kent.
Mm. Oh, God, it's from my mum. Always preaching it.
Yeah, well, she left it a bit late, didn't she?
Young. And Burns.
Oh, where'd that be from?
I don't know. Thanks, Mr. Fletcher.
Right, that's it, ladies.
From her husband, do you reckon?
Yeah, well, he hasn't been writing to her.
Well, it could be from. Dora doesn't usually get letters.
You gonna play or not, Lil?
Oh, right.
Shh. Go in here. Come on. Yeah. What do you want?
How's the lunch?
Well, it's good enough for the prisoners, so of course it's good enough for the officers. I hate the way everything's changing.
What do you mean?
Well, when I first started in the service, the idea was to make sure criminals were punished. Nowadays, we have to bend over backwards to make sure they're happy.
Listen, if a more liberal approach works, I'm all for it. I'm for anything that eases the strain of it.
Well, this visiting suite nonsense will just cause more. You just wait and see.
Yeah, I must admit I've got my doubts about it. Sounds all very well in theory, but will it work?
You know what they're like. They end up abusing every privilege they get.
Staff room. Yes, Julie. All right, I'll be right there. Ken Pierce has arrived for his visit. I have to search him. Will you get Smith?
Oh, would have been nice to be able to finish this lunch. Mm. Enjoy yourself.
See you again, Bee.
Hello, Ken.
You look terrific.
I did the best with what I had, which wasn't much to start with. Well, you want to go inside?
Yeah. I brought someone else to see you.
You know, B, with your interest in prisoners' rights, you ought to try doing the same sort of work as me when you're released.
Well, that's a bit far away to worry about, don't you think?
No. You'll find the time passes much more quickly when you're planning for the future. Now, you could do more than any screw or social worker to help the prisoners. I mean, you know their problems from personal experience. That makes a hell of a difference.
Yeah, I suppose it would.
And there's no university course could teach what you know about prisons. And you've done a great job in here as top dog. And you could do equally as good a job for the women once you're outside.
Things change, Ken, even in here.
Well, some things ought to be changed. Dad and I were searched before we were allowed to see you. And they made a very thorough job of it, too. Leave you without any dignity.
Lousy pigs. What do they think you're going to do? Smuggle the keys to the front gate into me or something?
Look, I expected it. I'm used to being searched by the screws. It doesn't worry me anymore.
Well, it sure worries me. Look, I can't thank you enough for what you did for me, Bee. When I think I could have ended up in a place like this.
Yeah.
Well, at least we've got these unsupervised visits. That's one hell of a breakthrough.
Yeah, I suppose it is.
Sorry, time's up.
Bye, Bee. I wish you were able to come to my wedding.
Yeah, so do I. Good luck for the future, Dom.
Thanks.
You keep up the good work, eh? I'll be back to see you as soon as I can.
Yeah, sure.
You and your daughter will have to report back to reception.
Why is that?
You have to be searched.
Oh, look, I'm not going through that again. It's ridiculous.
I'm sorry, we have to follow orders.
Go on, Debbie. While we're here, we may as well do it their way.
How was it then? Did you get what you were after? Was it worth what you did to us?
It was all right. It was unsupervised.
Oh, only all right, was it? Bit of a disappointment, eh?
It was no funny business. He had his daughter with him.
Oh, what did he do that for?
I suppose he thought I might like to see her.
So you missed out,
did you? No satisfaction, eh? Oh, that's what I call poetic justice. She sells out her mates and gets nothing back anyway. Oh, it's bloody lovely.
Disappointed you didn't find anything?
As I told you, I'm just doing my job.
Yes, of course.
Sign out before you leave.
Tell me, Mr. Fletcher, why don't you attend the PRG meetings any longer? You were interested enough in the welfare of Jackie Nolan to ask for help. Don't you think their other aims deserve your support?
Well, it's a bit awkward. Membership of the PRG could be seen as compromising my position as a prison officer.
Well, Mrs. Davidson doesn't seem to think so. She's a member. What really matters is how strongly you feel about prison reform.
Look, if the day ever comes when prisons are no longer necessary, I can assure you I won't regret losing my job.
But you're not very interested in helping along the way, eh?
No, I didn't say that. Here's your daughter. Make sure you sign up before you leave.
I can't wait to get out of here.
Thanks, mate.
I don't ever want to have to go through that again. Visiting anyone here just isn't worthwhile.
It is to the prisoners.
I can sure understand how Mum feels now, though, why she's so dead against your work.
No, she just didn't understand how important the work was.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
My name's Gray. I'm a reporter. I'm doing a follow-up story to the one on conjugal visits at Wentworth. You've just been visiting, have you?
Yes, that's right.
A conjugal visit?
Unsupervised, if that's what you mean. My daughter and I were visiting a close friend.
Who was that?
B. Smith.
B. Smith? I remember a story on her a while back.
Yes, I remember that story too. It was a pack of lies. Look, if you want to know more about this visiting scheme, why don't you talk to the governor, Mrs. Davidson?
I've already spoken to the department. But don't worry, this story will be in a positive vein. We want to do all we can to help with prison reform.
And well, I'm all for that.
Dad's one of the leading lights of the PRG.
Really? Could I have your name, sir?
Look, it's Ken Pierce, but I think that's beside the point. Look, if you're really interested in helping prisoners, you should point out what a morale booster this scheme is. Make it a story from the point of view of the prisoners rather than giving, well, more kudos to the department.
Yeah, we'll do that all right. I can work up a good story with the information you've given me. Thanks a lot, Mr. Pierce.
That'll be terrific if the papers support the scheme.
Yeah.
Spoil it.
Spoiled what?
Well, I got up early to get your breakfast and I'm going to bring it to you in bed.
Oh, that's a lovely thought, but whatever for?
Well, to celebrate your first day at the new job.
Oh, that's sweet of you.
You see, you should have stayed in bed.
What? And end up being late on my first day at work?
Well, anyway, you better have it. Come on.
Right, have you got your own ready?
Almost.
Oh, well, I'll go out and finish cooking.
No, you won't. You'll sit down and eat.
All right, all right. I don't mind being waited on hand and foot.
Oh, by the way, Meg, I'm going to have a business dinner later in the week. If you can be available.
Of course I will. Not only to attend, but to cook it. And I'll make something extra special.
Ah, good on you.
What have you got this scandal rag for? It's not your style.
You can say that again. The company's running an advertisement in each of those papers. I want to check that they're in there.
Can't see it.
I must be there somewhere.
Oh, no.
Well, they haven't made that much of a mess of it, have they?
Oh, look at this. It's about Wentworth. Look at the headline. Love nest for jailbirds. Oh,
there must be things going on there you haven't told me about.
Oh, this is dreadful. They talk about the visiting suite as a service station.
Well, you said yourself it was a rag. Where'd they get their information from?
That's what I'd like to know. They talk about Ken Pierce visiting B. Smith and make all sorts of nasty implications.
If Erica isn't careful, she'll find herself being referred to as Madam Erica.
It's not funny, Bob. There'll be repercussions about this.
Oh, come on, Meg. Who takes any notice of what they say?
Well, the department, for one thing. They'll hate it. Got a feeling my first day back at Wentworth we'll see some fireworks.
Oh, you ought to see this.
You took your time going to the loo.
I stopped to get the papers. You want to read the story in Verity. Oh, it's a wonder they didn't censor it. It's all about B and Ken.
What?
hear about him visiting you makes it sound as though you really got up to tricks.
We're not talking to her.
You talked to her yesterday when it suited you, and I can talk to her whenever I want.
Let me see that.
Look, love nest for jailbirds. Makes us sound as though we're a bunch of tarts, turning it on for any bloke who cared to call in.
Here, look at this bit. Double murderess B. Smith and well-known prison activist Ken Pierce were left unsupervised to enjoy the so-called conjugal rights of the new visiting suite commonly referred to as the Wentworth Love Nest. Oh.
That's really tough, B. You've had your name dragged through the mud already.
Yeah, and she just. They'll never consider you for parole in 100 years.
And what would have been your name in here, Chrissie, and not mine? Where would your precious parole be then?
Oh, what are you talking about?
Well, I made damn sure it was my name in here, none of yours, didn't I?
Are you trying to tell us you suspected this all along?
Of course I did.
Oh, load of old rubbish. Why?
Yeah, why?
Well, if you remember, our reason for boycotting the visiting suite was not just because of the officer interference, but because the department was taking all the glory from the good publicity, and we wanted to stop that, didn't we? Well, I reckon that should do the trick, don't you?
Do you mean that you and Ken did this just to make the department look bad?
Yeah, well, I've got nothing to lose. Some of the rest of you have.
Well, you silly cow. Why didn't you tell us instead of letting us walk all over you like that?
I tried to explain it, but none of you would listen to me.
Oh, B, you shouldn't have done it.
I gave another chance to see Ken, didn't I?
It was real bonzer of him to do that. Must have been really embarrassing for him.
Yeah.
Well, looks as though we had you all wrong, doesn't it? We should have known you wouldn't sell us out.
If they'd have written a smutty story like that about me and Mick, I'd never have got my parole.
We ought to have trusted our old mate. I'm real sorry that I didn't be.
Oh, that's all right. Maybe you'll all stick by me next time.
Look, get onto it straight away, will you? I want you to come down hard on them. Make them eat their words. Okay, mate, I'll leave it up to you.
Can your solicitor do something about it?
Yeah, I think we can get them for misrepresentation. You know, there isn't one mention in this article of the fact that you were with us the whole time. It implies I was there for one reason and one reason only.
Well, Mum isn't going to like it much.
Your mother can like it or lump it. She chose not to live with me. She can keep her nose out of my business.
Well, look, I'll give her a ring just the same. Explain what really happened, okay?
Well, please yourself, love. I'm more concerned about how Bee's feeling at the moment. She's bound to have seen this garbage.
Yeah, well, it's just as well Ken brought his daughter along with him. Knocks the story on the head for the department and lets us keep the visiting suite.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Go, you are clever, B. I wouldn't have thought of that in a million years.
It takes me to nouse, that's all.
Here comes Mrs. M. Oh, you do look beauty in civvies.
Hello, ladies. How
are you? You're a welfare officer now, aren't you, Mrs. M?
Yes, that's right, Lizzie. So I better not keep you from your work. Hurry along.
Even without a uniform, she keeps us moving.
Going to be around for a bit?
Yes, quite a while, Lizzie. Chrissie?
Yeah?
Can I have a word with you?
Yeah.
Well, are we going to your cell?
All right. Is it about my parole?
Well, more or less. I've spoken to Mick again, and I've arranged for him to visit you.
Oh, that's smashing, Mrs. Morris. Here, can we use the visiting suite then?
Well, not this time, but perhaps I can arrange it next time.
As long as my name doesn't get in the papers like B.
Yes, that was pretty unpleasant, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Tell me, Chrissie, do you and Mick intend to get married when you're released?
No, I don't know. I mean, I'm fond of him. I just don't think I want to spend the rest of my life with him, you know, tied down. I mean, when it boils down to it, all men are bastards one way or another, Mrs. Morris, aren't they?
Well, he does seem to care about you.
Oh, he does now, because we've only been together for a short time. You give him 2 years, he'll soon get sick of me.
Well, what about Elizabeth? He is her father.
That's another thing. Mick's asked me to ask you if you can get his name put on the birth certificate.
Well, there are a few formalities to go through, but I'm sure it can be done. Well, don't you see, Chrissie, if he wants that, he must be planning some sort of a future for you and Elizabeth.
Oh, I reckon Mick likes to be free. If he is planning anything, I don't think it could be that serious, honest.
Well, I wanted to tell you, I've been working on a report for your parole hearing, and I think you stand a pretty good chance of getting it. A lot will depend on what I can arrange for you as far as a job and accommodation are concerned.
Well, the main thing is to get Elizabeth. They will let me have her, won't they, Mrs. Morris?
Yes, well, I will be looking into that. If we can get everything else sorted out, I'm sure there'll be no problems there.
Latham, your visitor's arrived.
Oh, that'll be Mick now. I'll tell him that you're going to fix it up about the certificate. He'll be ever so pleased.
Yes, you run along and tell him.
You're a good sport, Mrs. Morris. I reckon you're going to make a great social worker.
How you going, Chrissie?
I'm all right. How are things with you?
Working hard.
Tom.
I went to see Elizabeth again.
Yeah? Oh, how is she?
Oh, fantastic. I still can't believe she's my own kid. I mean, she's really beautiful.
Yeah. I reckon she takes after her mum.
Well, she looks a bit like me.
Well, of course she does.
Listen, you're going to get out of here, all right? The parole going to come through, you reckon?
Well, I reckon it will, as long as I've got somewhere to live and some way of earning money, you know? I mean, I don't want to go back to earning it like I was before, do I?
There's no need to worry about that, Chrissie. Listen, I've been thinking about us.
Yeah?
Well, now we've got Elizabeth and everything, I reckon we ought to think about making it legal.
You mean get married?
Well, I want to do the right thing by you and me daughter. Will you marry me, Chrissie?
Julie, if anyone rings for me, could you please take a message? I haven't got an office to use as yet, and I'll be moving around the building quite a bit.
Okay.
Everything all right, Mick?
I was wondering if I could talk to you, Mrs. Morris.
Yes, of course.
Chrissie said you were going to see about getting me name put on the kid's birth certificate.
Yes, well, I'm sure I can arrange it. I think it's good that you want it done.
Yeah, well, I want to look after both of them, and that's what I wanted to talk to you about. I asked Chrissie to marry me, but, well, she wouldn't give me a straight answer. I thought she'd jump at it.
Well, sometimes you have to give a woman time to think things over, especially things like that.
Yeah, but, well, I really care about her, and, well, if she was going to get married, it'd help her get a parole, wouldn't it?
Well, yes, I dare say it would, especially if you're able to give her a home and support her properly.
Oh, I would. I've been working real hard.
Well, if you have a regular job and could find somewhere decent for you and Chrissie to live, it'd help a great deal. Look, why don't you do that first, and then let her decide if she wants to get married?
All right. Funny, but a woman not wanting to marry a bloke, especially when she's had his kid.
Well, as I said, Mick, I think you've got to give it time. She just mightn't have been expecting you to propose.
All right. Thanks very much, Mrs. Morrison. I'll see about getting some sort of a house, something with a bit of a yard for the kid to play.
Good. Well, good luck, Mick.
Mrs. Morris?
Ah, hello, Debbie.
I was pretty sure it was you. Of course, I've never seen you out of uniform before.
Well, you won't be seeing me back in it again. I'm a welfare officer now.
Oh, that's great. I was wondering if I'd be able to see B. Smith.
Well, you saw her yesterday with your father, didn't you?
Yes, that's right, but I don't want to see her unsupervised, so I won't have to be searched again, will I?
I shouldn't think so. That is, if you are permitted to see her. Well, the prisoners are only allowed one visitor per week. You'll have to get Mrs. Davidson's permission.
Oh, can you arrange for me to see her?
Yes, of course. Will you just sign in first?
Thanks.
Love, I thought you'd be as happy as a lark.
How can I be happy after that?
Yeah. It was awful, wasn't it? But I thought you'd know that when you arranged it.
Arranged it?
You mean you didn't do it?
Not exactly.
But you said that you...
I know what I said, Lizzie. But it wasn't just for the other women, it was for me too.
You mean that you made all that up?
Some of it. To get the women back on side.
Well, I couldn't understand why you'd done it. Gaw, you must have got an awful shock when you read that story. I'm still a bit confused, though, B.
Oh, it's pretty simple, really, Lizzie. They were right. I did sell them out. The screw just had to dangle the bait of a private visit with Ken in front of my nose, and I took it hook, line, and sinker. But you should understand how I felt, Lizzie. Being in here all these years and having no visitors. I've almost forgotten what it's like to be spoken to gently by a man. And I wanted that, Lizzie. I wanted to see Ken again, and I wanted to have him to myself for a while. I don't want to. I don't want to dry up without ever being held by a man again. Without ever being loved. I was thinking more of myself than I was of my mates. You gotta think of yourself sometimes, love. You needn't worry, Bee.
I won't tell nobody. It'll just be a secret between you and me. That bloody Ken Pierce. Fancy bringing his daughter with him. I hope he's got more sense next time.
Next time? Oh, Lizzie. Is it going to be next time?
Of course there is, love.
Hello, Davey. I understand you want to see B. Smith.
Yes, I want to explain about that dreadful newspaper article. Well, the reporter took what Dad and I said and twisted it all.
So that's where the story originated.
Well, the reporter said he wanted to do a story in support of the new visiting scheme. Well, then he just wrote what he wanted to. Dad's taking legal action.
Well, I'm very glad to hear he is, but I don't see that what you have to say to Smith warrants another visit. And I am curious as to why your father didn't come himself.
Well, there was something else I wanted to say to Bee. Something personal. Well, I've tried to talk to Dad about it, but he just won't listen to me. He thinks a lot of Bee, and well, she might be able to get through to him. It really is important, Mrs. Davidson.
Very well, you may have a brief visit with Smith.
Feeling better now?
Oh, yeah, about as good as I'm getting, I reckon. Oh, what a wreck. I suppose I might as well return this to Doreen. Don't need to pretty myself up for anyone anymore.
You could be wrong. Ken might come back.
Fat chance.
What are you two doing in here? You should be working in the laundry.
Oh, my ticker was playing up a bit, so I thought I'd need a bit of a rest, and Bee came to see if I was okay.
Well, perhaps you should see Sister Franklin.
Oh, no, I'll be all right. We'll be getting back the laundry, eh?
Yeah.
Not you, Smith. You got a visitor. In the governor's office.
A visitor?
Oh, it's not Ken Pierce, is it, Mr. Fletcher?
Just get to the laundry, Lizzie. Come on, Smith.
Well, I hope it is, Bee.
I don't see how it could be.
Mrs. M, do you know who B's visitor is?
I might, but she'll tell you herself when she comes back.
Oh, nobody will tell you anything in this bloody joint.
Oh, Chrissie, I was just going to see you in the laundry.
Oh, no, I've just been to the loo. Well, what did you want to see me about, Mrs. Morris? Any news about Elizabeth?
Yes, I've made a few inquiries. Now, if your parole comes through, you'll be allowed to have contact visits with Elizabeth.
Contact visits? Well, sounds like she's in jail. Why can't I have her back proper?
Now, just a minute. As I said, you'll be allowed contact visits and you'll be able to take her out one full day a week. That's until you can prove that you can look after her properly. And when you can prove that, you'll be able to have her full time with no interference. Look, it would be a lot easier if you had a home and a job to go to, but at the moment you've got neither. Now, Mick told me he proposed to you. I suggest you think about it very carefully. He seems to really care for you. And it could be the answer to all your problems.
Ah, oh, Debbie.
Hi, Bee.
You come on your own, did you?
Yeah, Dad's pretty busy, so I told him I'd come and explain about that newspaper article.
I've told Miss Pierce she can only have a few minutes with you, Smith. As you know, you're not due for another visit until next week.
You see, some reporter talked to us when we left here. Well, I was silly enough to mention your name. And then he found out who Dad was and just went away and made up that horrible story. Dad's really upset about it.
Yeah, I bet he is.
Upset for you, I mean. Oh. Well, he's going to sue them.
That's something to worry about me. My reputation's shot to hell already anyway. But I wouldn't like to see it hurt Ken.
Oh, he reckons he can take anything they can dish out. Of course, Mum won't like it.
Well, why should she care? They're separated, aren't they?
Well, that's really what I wanted to talk to you about, Bee.
What do you mean?
Well, Mum waited the whole time Dad was inside. And then when he got out, well, she wanted him to start a new life and have nothing to do with prison. But, of course, he wouldn't. He'd made up his mind he wanted to work on prison reform. Mum just couldn't take it.
Is that why they split up?
Yeah, just 3 months after he got out. The thing is, I know they still love each other, even though they won't admit it.
They still love each other?
Yeah, I know they do. Look, I'm getting married and I'm real happy. And because I am, I want to see them happy too. Oh, I've tried to talk Dad into giving up his work and he won't, and Mum won't listen when I tell her she ought to accept his. They're both too proud to give in.
Look, what are you telling me all this for?
You helped me once before, Bea. You made me realise what an idiot I was being. And then you talked about the importance of family love. Well, that's why I thought perhaps you might help me now.
Help you? Help you how?
Dad really respects you. He might listen to you, Bea. Will you talk to him? Try and persuade him to go back to Mum?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare. Comes around.